Hello, everybody. My name is Johnny Goodnews, and this lovely lady at my side is Susan Crowe.
Hello, everybody. This is what we have today on Amazing News.
First, Erica will interview a rock band. Hi, Erica. Tell us about your interview.
Hi, Johnny. We are here with the famous rock band Gordo Lobo.
Lobo Moro. The band is called Lobo Moro.
Of course, darling. And we will talk about their new album.
After Erica's interview, we'll move to another part of town, where Michael Fossey is standing to report on a new restaurant. Hello, Michael. Tell us, how did you find this new restaurant?
Hi, Johnny. Last Friday, I was walking down Revolution Street when I saw a long line of people standing on the sidewalk. They were waiting for something, and I didn't know what. So I asked one of them, "Why are you waiting here?" She explained to me that it was the opening of La Chiva Chula, a very fine restaurant. Many people wanted to eat here.
Oh, I heard about that restaurant. It seems that they are going to have a lot of success.
Well, we'll find out on my report today on Amazing News.
Thank you, Michael. We'll see you later. What else do we have, Susan?
We have a special report from Jackie Runner, who will tell us about a new sport that is gaining popularity. What is it about, Jackie?
Oh, it's really amazing and exciting, Susan. I came to this gym to take part of the latest sports sensation. Last week, I was having a conversation about new sports when a friend told me about this place. You'll have to see it to believe it.
Thank you, Jackie. We will come back to you for your report in a while. We will also have our amazing reports on the weather with Willie Weatherman.
Thank you, Johnny. We have bad, bad news.
Special reports, international news, and much more.
Stay tuned.
Amazing News.
Lengua adicional al español 3. Programa 3. Actividades que se desarrollaron en el pasado.
Hello again. I'm Susan Crowe. I know it's impossible to be completely happy, but I hope you're feeling okay. Welcome to Amazing News. We know it's not perfect, but we try our best.
What are you talking about, Susan? We have a great show for today. The best show you can imagine. Because we want to make you absolutely happy.
Anyway, first, some quick news clips from around the world. A group of scientists found a very valuable treasure. It was lying at the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean, close to the French coast. The treasure chest contained gold coins and many types of gems. All along the week, scientists were trying to find out its exact value. One of them said it could be worth about 100 million pesos. Nothing good will come out of this. I don't like talking about money. It's bad.
Don't talk like that, Susan. Money can be used for very helpful things, too, like helping people in need, or distribution of vaccines, or many things. Yesterday in China, a fire destroyed an historical building. A family of Mexican tourists was visiting the place. They discovered flames and called the firefighters, but it was too late. That's too bad, but they can build something else instead, right? Renovation is always a good thing.
Thank you, Johnny. Now, let's talk about music. We'll hear what Erica Gossip has to tell us about the Lobo Moro rock band. Hi, Erica.
This is another interesting report from our amazing Erica Gossip.
Hi, Susan, and hello, all of you. I'm here with my friends of the Gordo Lobo Band, and they have...
Lobo Moro. The band is called Lobo Moro.
That's right. I'm here with my friends of the Gordo Moro Band, and they have a lot of things going on right now. Tell us about them.
Well, we were recording some new songs a few months ago. Our manager was listening to them, and he fell asleep. Yeah, it was, so I told him, let's play faster and louder. And we did it, and our manager woke up. We don't want our audience to fall asleep, so we decided to play everything loud and fast. That's right. So now we have a bunch of loud and fast songs. And they are all in this Faster and Louder album.
Wow, it's interesting. And what's the name of your new movie?
Album. It's an album. It's called Faster and Louder.
Yes, it's really a great name for a movie. And do you have any plans for it?
Sure. We were planning to have only 2 or 3 concerts because in the past, the audience used to fall asleep or left the place before the show was over. Yeah, but now we think we sound great. So we're going on a huge tour with lots of concerts. And those concerts will be fast and loud.
Perfect. And remember, my friends, Gordo Lobo Band will visit your town soon. Don't forget to watch them in Lomo Roto movie. Back to you, Johnny.
That was another interesting report with our lovely Erica Gossip.
Thank you for that wonderful interview, Erica. Tell me, Susan, was the band's name Gordo Lobo, Lobo Moro, Lomo Roto?
It's what? The famous band, Lobo Moro, Johnny. Oh, I love their hit song, Que Lobo Tan Cotorro.
¿Qué lobo tan cotorro?
Perdona, Johnny. Creo que es momento de aprovechar para un importante repaso gramatical.
Hello, Mr. Director. It seems fine to me. I can take a minute to savor this delicious cup of coffee.
Gracias, Johnny. Nosotros podemos hacer una pausa para recordar lo que hemos visto y escuchado hasta ahora. Mucha atención con las palabras que aparecen subrayadas. ¿Qué tienen en común?
The treasure chest contained gold coins and many types of gems. All along the week, scientists were trying to find out its exact value. One of them said it could be worth about 100 million pesos.
Well, we were recording some new songs a few months ago. Our manager was listening to them and he fell asleep. Yeah, it was, so I told him, let's play faster and louder. And we did it, and our manager woke up.
Así es. Se trata de enunciados que se refieren al pasado. Esos verbos hablan de sucesos anteriores. Pero como vieron, se trata de dos tiempos verbales distintos. Hay verbos conjugados en pasado simple o simple past, como told, said, did y contained. Ya conocen la forma de conjugar los verbos en simple past. Como recuerdan, algunos son regulares y otros irregulares. Este tiempo verbal se utiliza para referirse a sucesos que tuvieron lugar en un momento específico o en una sola ocasión en el pasado. La forma de componer enunciados en este tiempo verbal es muy sencilla. Generalmente se comienza con el sujeto, seguido del verbo en simple past y finalizando con el complemento. Así sucede con el enunciado. The treasure contained gold coins and many types of gems. Por otra parte, hay verbos que están conjugados en un tiempo verbal llamado pasado continuo o past continuous, como we're trying, we're recording y was listening. El past continuous nos sirve para referirnos a acciones o situaciones que tuvieron lugar durante un periodo amplio. Este tiempo verbal se forma de manera similar al presente continuo, con el verbo to be conjugado de acuerdo al sujeto y seguido de la forma verbal básica, con la terminación ing. Pero en este caso, el verbo to be va conjugado en pasado. Así, con el verbo listen, la conjugación del pasado continuo con todos los pronombres sería como sigue. I was listening. You were listening. He, she, it was listening. We were listening. They were listening. Estos irían seguidos del complemento según sea el caso. Como en el ejemplo que vimos.
Well, we were recording some new songs a few months ago. Our manager was listening to them and he fell asleep.
Listo, es todo por ahora. Volvemos con ustedes al estudio.
Thank you, mysterious voice. I like cloudy days very much. I like it especially when it rains. The sun bothers me with all its happiness.
Well, I love happiness. Let's go to the weather forecast with Willie Weatherman. Hey, Willie, will it be cloudy or sunny today?
This is amazing weather, good and bad with Willie Weatherman.
Thank you, Johnny. We have bad, bad news. This will make you very sad. First, it will be very cloudy and cold. You should wear a sweater and maybe mittens. Later this afternoon, it will rain. An awful thing for sure. You will need an umbrella. A raincoat. And a pair of boots. We will all get wet. We might catch the flu.
It all sounds logical to me, Willie. Mm-hmm. I knew it was gonna be an awful day today. I could have a cup of tea while I watch the rain.
But wait, Susan. There is bad news for you. Terrible news. After the rain, the sun will come out. It will be all warm and bright. You will need to take care of your raincoat and your sweater. Your eyes will be blinded by the light. You should wear shorts and a t-shirt. Also, remember to take your sunglasses with you and a sunscreen.
That was amazing weather with Willie Weatherman.
That's right, Willie. That's terrible news. Well, what can you do? Thanks for your report.
It's time to talk about a new restaurant. Now, restaurants are really nice places. We all like good food, right?
Johnny, but food can make you sick if they don't cook it right. Some restaurants are really expensive, and others have really bad service.
Anyway, Michael Fossey went to a new restaurant that seems to be excellent. Here's what happened.
And now, an amazing report from our star reporter, Michael Fossey.
That's right, Johnny. I'm here at the amazing La Chiva Chula restaurant. I came back on Monday when the restaurant was just opening its doors. It was empty this time. And now, I'm going to interview Chef Erasmo.
This restaurant, it's fabulous. It's driving people crazy. Hey, I'm here with Chef Erasmo. He is the chef of La Chiva Chula. Tell us, Erasmo, what have you prepared for us today?
Well, we wanted to create a new concept of Mexican.
Yes. You can tell us about the concept later. Right now, we would like to know, how do you cook these very interesting dishes?
Well, right here, we have a vegetarian hamburger. It has large mushrooms instead of bread. And in the inside, it has many different fresh vegetables. I had the ingredients, so I started creating.
And what is the recipe for this marvelous hamburger?
First, I noticed I had a lot of different fresh vegetables. Lettuce, cucumbers, tomatoes, zucchinis, onions. Then I started chopping them with a sharp knife and frying them in a pan. While they were frying, I added some butter and garlic. After that, I took two slices of portobello mushrooms and toasted them just a little. Finally, I used these slices as bread and added the vegetables between them.
Let me tell you, this is amazing!
Well, thank you. I take my job very seriously.
Maybe a little ketchup will make it better?
No, not ketchup. This is a work of art.
But ketchup can also be a work of art. It has tomatoes and some vinegar and lots of sugar. Look at it. It's beautiful. Well, but don't get distracted, Erasmo. We would like to know about your next dish.
Well, this is my favorite creation. I thought about making it one day when I was feeling so happy.
Okay, I'm sorry. I do care about your feelings, but right now we would like to know about this recipe.
Okay. This is fried fish with strawberries. It is served with lettuce and potatoes. You may want to know how I made it.
Well, let me tell you, fish and strawberry, that doesn't sound tasty at all. It's so tasty!
Of course it's tasty. This is the recipe. First, I fry the fish with garlic in olive oil. Later, I slice the strawberries and the lettuce. After a while, the fish was ready, so I served it. Finally, I added the strawberries and the lettuce on top.
That's amazing!
Some minutes later, the potatoes were ready, so I fried them and placed them next to the fish. And here it is.
Chef Erasmo, you are an incredible cook.
This is something I am very proud of.
And it looks wonderful. What is it?
It's a Mexican-style lasagna. It has shrimp, cilantro, and chili.
You have to come to this amazing new restaurant. You will be happy you came. Back to you, Susan.
That was Michael Fuzzy with an amazing report.
That was Michael Fuzzy reporting from La Chiva Chula, a good place to find interesting food for sure. Maybe not to my taste, but fried fish with strawberries?
Bueno, Susan, creo que nos vendría bien detenernos un momento ahora.
I think you're right. Maybe it's a good time to take a break. I'm not feeling well right now. I'm kind of depressed.
No digas eso, Susan. Eres una gran conductora. Esto no es personal, lo sabes.
I'll be right back.
Vamos a reforzar algo de lo que acabamos de ver. Cuando relatamos sucesos del pasado, hay varias palabras que nos sirven para relacionarlos entre sí o para describir la secuencia en que tuvieron lugar. Atención con las palabras que aparecen en pantalla.
Of course it's tasty. This is the recipe. First, I fry the fish with garlic in olive oil. Later, I slice the strawberries and the lettuce. After a while, the fish was ready, so I served it. Finally, I added the strawberries and the lettuce on top.
That's amazing!
Some minutes later, the potatoes were ready, so I fried them and placed them next to the fish. And here it is.
¿De qué se tratan estas palabras? Veamos. First, after y later son palabras que pertenecen a un grupo conocido como conectores. Estas palabras nos ayudan a relacionar varios eventos entre sí, ordenándolos en el tiempo. Cuando se trata de acontecimientos pasados, nos ayudan a saber cuál evento sucedió primero y cuál después. En este caso, first indica el primer suceso de una cadena de acciones. After se refiere a lo que sucede justo después de otro momento del que se habla. Y later indica algo que sucede más tarde de una forma no inmediata. Así tendríamos, por ejemplo,
first, I woke up. I got dressed after taking a shower. Later, I went to school.
Tengan cuidado de identificar cuándo se usa la expresión after a while. Ahí, while se refiere a un momento o rato. Por ejemplo,
I was reading, and after a while, I fell asleep.
Y no sería el mismo uso que el que veremos a continuación.
Y es todo por el momento. Gracias por dejarme este espacio, amigos. El micrófono es suyo otra vez.
It's always a pleasure, mysterious voice. We have heard about a lot of new sports during the last years, but this is one of the strangest. Let's listen to Jackie Runner's story. Over to you, Jackie.
This is Amazing Sports with Jackie Runner.
Let me tell you, Johnny, these are some exciting races we are talking about. Do you see what I mean? Join me and watch the next race so you can see for yourselves. Right now, the athletes are getting ready. You can feel the tension in the air. And here they come. Number one jumps his lane. Number two leaves the race. Number three doesn't know how to do a somersault. And that leaves only number four, who is our champion. Wow, that was fast. Let's watch a slow motion replay to see what happened. Number one started off well, but he lost his way after that. He got disqualified while number two is getting dizzy. Number two was stepping out to go to the bathroom when number three found out that she didn't know how to do a somersault. Number four finished the race while number three was trying to make his first somersault. All in all, it was a great race. I think each of them made a great effort. They all deserve to win. That's the end of my report on an amazing new sport. Over to you, Johnny.
That was Jackie Runner with Amazing Sports.
Interesting for sure. Thank you, Jackie.
Johnny, we have a special report from Erica Gossip. She says she just found the smallest dog in the world.
Smallest dog? What's that about?
Well, I'm not quite sure, but what I do know is that it must be fascinating. Erica, where are you?
This is another interesting report from our amazing Erica Gossip.
Hi, Susan. I was walking to the studio when I saw the smallest dog in the world. Look. Before you go on, Erica, that's not a living dog. That's a toy.
Of course not. Look, those are his little legs and his little head.
Those are not real. It looks like plastic. It's a toy, Erica. Put your glasses on.
But are you sure? It looks so real.
That was another interesting report with our lovely Erica Gossip.
Don't you worry, Erica. I think you're doing a great job. You still found a beautiful toy dog. Congratulations.
¿Adivinen qué? Es tiempo de mi última intervención.
Perfect. You always interrupt right on time. Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna take a nap while the mysterious voice talks.
Veamos qué sucedió en las secuencias anteriores. Atención con las palabras que aparecerán subrayadas en pantalla.
Number 4 finished the race while number 3 was trying to make his first somersault.
I was walking to the studio when I saw the smallest dog in the world.
When y while pertenecen a una clase de palabras llamadas pronombres relativos. Como su nombre indica, sirven para poner un suceso en relación con otro. En este caso se trata de una relación en el tiempo. When cuando se utiliza para referirse al pasado, anticipa un suceso que generalmente se narra en simple past y toma como contexto un acontecimiento narrado en past continuous. Es como si el suceso en simple past irrumpiera en el que se cuenta en past continuous. Así tendríamos, por ejemplo, Clara was sleeping when the phone rang. While tiene la misma función, pero en sentido inverso. Indica un suceso en past continuous y toma como referencia uno narrado en simple past. Tomando el caso del enunciado anterior, tendríamos The phone rang while Clara was sleeping. Y hasta aquí llega mi participación. Gracias a Susan y Johnny en el estudio. Y gracias a todos ustedes por escuchar.
And I think we have finished as well. This has been amazing news for today. Isn't that right, Susan?
That's right, Johnny. It's too bad we have to say goodbye. Have a good day. At least a normal day. So long, everybody.
May you all have tons of optimism, lots of light, and happiness.
Stop it, Johnny. Ya bájale.
Of course, Susie. I'm sorry. We'll see you soon on another program of amazing news. And you, have a lovely day.